mag-ano ka, mag-Netflix and chill ka dyan sa bahay. Or kung may VPN yeah. ka,
so mag-Disney Netflix and chill.
Or mag-pirate ka ng videos or whatever you wanna do.
Ay, wag! Hello, mga
Hello, mga ka-Arki.
And I hope you are all doing well, staying safe and staying healthy.
Yes.
Kamusta, Adriel?
Ayun, bagong gising ngayong Sabado.
No. Bagong gising. Okay. So
nakaligo lang, fresh. Fresh
wow.
from
the... Sana all fresh.
Okay. Sana all fresh, bagong gising.
So, I hope you're all ready to learn dito sa ating video. Mm-hmm. And ano ba ang topic natin, Adriel?
So, yung topic natin ngayon, very interesting, no? Sa lahat ng mga freelancers there, aspiring freelancers, or aspiring self-employed. Dahil, magdi-discuss tayo tungkol paano natin pipiliin yung mga side hustle natin, or what's the best side hustle for me to pursue.
Oo. So, how to choose the side hustle that's right for you. And I think hindi lang to limited sa mga gustong maging freelancer. Sa tingin ko lahat magbe-benefit dito kahit na full-time employee ako pero gusto ko ng extra income, then definitely I can find or I will try to look for a side hustle na kaya kong gawin during my free time para naman meron tayong extra money na pang online shopping.
Shopping. Kailangan for those 9-9, 10-10, December sale.
Oo. We're entering the holiday season, so definitely mas magiging maingay na yung mga online sale na yan. Mm-hmm. And kung gusto natin na meron tayong budget for those kind of things, then probably maganda na magsimula na ngayon pa lang na maghanap na tayo ng extra income para hindi masisira yung budget natin. Siyempre yung main source of income natin para sa ating daily and monthly necessities. So at least kung meron tayong side hustle, meron tayo para sa mga ibang wants natin. So ano bang mga mai-advise natin, Adriel, sa mga gustong magkaroon ng side hustle? Ano ba yung mga tips na naiisip mo?
So the first tip, no, when choosing your side hustle or whatever you want to pursue as a side hustle or freelance, no, is to know what skills you have and what skills you are willing to learn. Important yan. Willing, no? Because kung hindi ka naman willing to learn this type of skill or whatever path you want, no, medyo mahirapan ka along the line when you're doing the side hustle already. And baka di naman madidepress, pero like mawawala yung interest mo in doing the side hustle.
Nakademotivate.
Yes, mawawala yung motivation mo to do it, no? So, the reason why then I want to emphasize yung skills first because it will lead you to action eh. And then from that, magiging motivated to do it in the long run or consistently.
So, it's important to emphasize na it not necessarily na meron ka na nung skill na yon, but you're interested or willing to learn that skill.
And also, just to add, no, I believe that every one of us, no, lahat tayo, kaya natin magtuto ng bagong skill, no? It's just a matter of your own mindset, no, on how to do it. And just to cite my personal example, no, I just started my gaming channel a week ago.
Wow, but before gamer.
That, gamers, so go gamers. So besides that, I had to learn how to do video editing by myself. I had to learn design dahil ako lang gumagawa ng thumbnails. And then, of course, presentation skills will also matter now even more. No, so I had to like consistently learn how to present what I'm presenting, no? Because I want the video, no, that I will be presenting to my audience na something useful, something of value din. So, no, just to highlight, di ako video editor before, but because I wanted to have a gaming channel, so I had to learn how to edit.
Yes. So you should have the skill, or at the very least, you are willing to learn that skill. So yun, very important yun if you're thinking or you're looking for a side hustle. Para sa akin, you should also look at your schedule. So one of the things that you need to consider is yung time. Yan. Mm-hmm. Anything that you want to say about that, yung about your free time?
Yeah, besides no yung skills, importante yung scheduling because this would again lead to like pacing yourself, no. Again, being in a side hustle can be yun yung hassle or something na medyo matabaho, no, on top of your current workload. So it's important to pace yourself and use yung free time mo as efficiently as possible. I don't want to say productive because pagiging productive naman tayo once we use the time efficiently. So bale, how do you make your time efficient now? So instead of like every day I have to do this, mag-dedicate ka ng certain time of the week to like focus on your side hustle para hindi ka mag-burnout, mapagod. And at the same time, you have other time or like other things in your free time to do, like time with your family, have a break, mag-ano ka, mag-Netflix and chill ka dyan sa bahay. Or kung may VPN ka,
so mag-Disney Plus. So Netflix and chill.
Or mag-pirate ka ng videos or whatever you wanna do.
Ay, wag!
Joke lang. But like,
we don't condone that.
Sorry. But like, you get the point, di ba? So like, yes, you have to pace yourself or schedule certain times of the week for your side hustle. Para lang you get the feel on how it works and how the pacing goes depending on the field. Because depende kasi kung anong side hustle mo, yun kasi magdi-dictate, no? So let's say copywriter ka. So baka twice a week you do copywriting or three times a week you do copywriting. Or if you want to do video editing, baka mas matrabaho siya. So baka twice a week lang or once a week or baka weekends lang. Mm-hmm. Or let's say in my case, nag-YouTube channel ako. So mga once or twice a week, I just post videos. And during the weekend, nag-video shoot ako and edit. Or kung hindi ko kaya mag-video edit during the weekend, I dedicate time during the week then to video edit it. Video edit my videos and then I do my thesis after. So mga ganung balancing. So it's a balancing act and it depends per person. So discardin nyo na yan.
No. Oh, so it's important to be honest about your schedule. Mas maganda siguro na we really lay out kung ano ba yung mga ginagawa natin every week. Ano ba yung mga necessary tasks that we need to do? And mas magbibigyan tayo ng magandang overview kung gaano karami ba talaga yung free time na meron tayo. Yeah. However, don't forget to include yung times for rest and relaxation and also time for sleep and spending time with your friends and family dun sa schedule. Hindi pwedeng puro trabaho, no? Hindi I also don't believe dun sa hustle culture na
hustle kasi yung hustle culture.
Oo. Yung lahat ng free time mo i-dedicate mo para sa mga hustle mo, no, or sa mga sideline gigs mo, no. I also do not believe that. I sometimes even schedule mga whole day for me na no work kasi ganun ka importante sa akin yung na re-replenish ko yung energy ko. Tapos meron akong ano, self-care day nga, no? And again, the important thing is to be honest with your schedule. Be self-aware kung ano ba talaga yung kaya mong gawin. Kasi kahit na 1 or 2 hours a week lang yung totoo mong free time, I think there's still something that you can do. So yung 2 hours a week na free time mo, I'm very sure makakahanap ka ng side hustle na magagawa mo during that period na kikita ka pa rin ng pera. Yun. So, any other tips, Adriel?
So, besides no, getting the skills and pacing yourself, eventually, no, but this is like medyo late, no? Like in the middle or late na towards your side hustle is to create your team. No? Because having that team would be like, would help you then. Like keep it sustainable and then what else, like at least you can delegate tasks that you normally do and then you can focus on the thing that's most important for your side hustle so that eventually now if you want you can turn it to a full-time job, but if you want to stay it into a hustle, okay lang din. Now it again depends on the person and what you want to do.
Yeah, at least you can check if there's potential dahil tama ka, karamihan ng mga side hustle has the potential to grow into a business and you can definitely scale it up. If you scale it up, your income also goes up. And part of that is creating a team simply means checking if there are tasks that you can delegate, there are, or if there are tasks that you can outsource, no?
Yeah. So, and another thing, no, when creating a team is that, sorry, medyo bagong gising, but like, like you can involve your family and friends already in whatever side hustle that you do, because another benefit, no, is you have that support group that encourages you to continue doing it. And that will like continue the motivation for you, and then at least no mayroon kang cushion to lean on in case something goes wrong, no, in your side hustle, no. Para may ano ka rin, like cheerleading team or moral team.
Yes, yes. That's also very important, having a support system of people, kasi minsan nakakapagod nga rin 'yan. And katulad ng mga ibang YouTubers na napapanood ko, nung pisa sila lang mag-isa. Pero later on, di ba, involved na rin yung kasama nila sa bahay, yung kapatid, yung magulang, nasa YouTube videos na rin nila. So I think kasi, syempre, nakaka-enjoy din gawin ang isang bagay kung yung mga kasama mo sa bahay ay nahihingian mo ng tulong and support. So yun, kung ano yung specific na side hustle na ipupursue nila, again, it really depends on your skill. It depends on your free time that you can dedicate. And also, I would say, depende talaga kung ano yung interested ka or ano yung willing ka talagang pag-aralan. Among the popular side hustles right now is, of course, being an online freelancer. Maraming mga pwedeng gawin as an online freelancer. Pwedeng freelance writer, virtual assistant, social media manager, etc. Pwede rin tayong maging content creator katulad ng ginagawa mo ngayon, Adriel, di ba? Meron kang YouTube channel. But hindi lang kasi YouTube or blogging, maski yung mga short form videos like TikTok, pwede na rin siyang ma-monetize, no? Ang important sa pagiging content creator ay meron kang particular topic na hindi ka magsasawa na i-discuss. Yun yung masasabi ko lang, no? Of course, may mga traditional na side hustles na hahanap ka ng part-time job. Kasi ginagawa ko yan dati na may mga friends ako na, oy, pwede ba pag weekend, ano, part-time ako magtrabaho dyan sa inyo? I can consider that as a side hustle. Particularly, yung isa kong friend na photographer, pag meron siyang shoot, ano ako, assistant ako. So, alam mo yun, it's still extra income for me. And may idadagdag ka pa ba, Adriel, na mga common or popular side hustle ngayon?
I think na-discuss na natin lahat ng popular side hustles, but just to like end the video and last tip na is to just focus on one side hustle and not make every interest as a side hustle, dahil medyo mahirap yan. The reason for this is that if you like divide the focus everywhere, medyo sabog yung mangyayari na output. But if you like focus your attention on one side hustle, then the fruits of your labor would grow exponentially in the long run. And another reason for this is that at least yung other interest mo, you can use it for your free time to rest, no, or relax, or do like self-care day or me day, no, because ayaw natin na lahat nagiging trabaho or nagiging chore na lang siya. So that's something like very important to note. Baka kasi lahat, no, someone watching this video might think na, oh, lahat ng interest ko pwede maging side hustle. But like, just focus on one. And then once okay na yung isa, you can venture on other hustles na. But I would suggest to know your limits din. Baka kasi you might stretch yourself out and then nagbo-burn out ka. So
tama. Tama. Oo. Meron ako kakilala, nag-online freelancing on the side, nag-aaral din mag-stock trading. Tapos, pag weekend, nag-online nagla-live selling, 'di ba? Sabi ko, dami mo masyado ginagawa, hindi ka ba napapagod diyan? So, pagdating sa side hustle, it's yeah, tama 'yung sinabi mo. Focus on just one. Try to build your skill set doon sa particular na side hustle na 'yon, and then once you are able to, sabi nga natin kanina, scale up, outsource some of the task, delegate some of the task, and you find yourself a little bit with a little bit more of free time, then siguro that's the time that you venture out to another side hustle. So yun. Yes. Ako, maraming salamat, Adriel, sa pagsama sa akin dito sa video na to. And I hope maraming natutunan yung mga ka-Arki natin, lalo na sa mga naghahanap ng paraan para kumita ng extra sa panahon ngayon. Yes. So, if you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up and share it to your friends. And please remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel.
Yes, and don't forget to, of course, click that notification bell so that you won't miss a thing.
And alright, so maraming salamat, yes. Adriel. Yan.
And, balik-tulog na tayo.
So, muli sa susunod nating video, makita-kita tayo. Okay, so bye-bye.
Bye, ingat guys.